Don't take anything you plug into a wall outlet into the bathroom.
If you have a DC 5000 camera with the Codec identifier KJCAA followed by an 8-digit serial number, contact your dealer.
I'll tell you what, if you own one of these cameras, go to thescreensavers.com. We've got a link to fill out a registration form, and you'll receive a mailer to send back the camera.
The killer camera!
It is not a killer camera, hype monster.
I'm going to get the letter from Kodak's lawyers, don't you think?
The killer camera's on the loose!
Finally! What came out today that has you all excited?
Oh, well, XP Service Pack is out today, and trust me when I say you must download and install it. It could be big.
Although you may not want to download and install it.
It's big. How big is it?
It's about the full possible version of it, as I understand, is a 133 megabyte download.
Yeah!
If you download the express version of it, it's a 1.9 megabyte download, which searches your system, looks to see what updates you need, and then they say, on average, they expect it to download about 30 additional megabytes of stuff onto
just
your system.
On how up to date your system is.
What's
However,
really interesting
yes.
is, take a look down here. Now, as far as we know, this is actually...
Oh, you know, folks, this was the rumor.
This was the rumor.
This was the rumor that they were going to build into it a check on the serial number to make sure you had a legitimate serial number. Look what happened with Patrick when he tried to upgrade on a completely, perfectly reasonable installation.
Yeah, that's what bothers me. Is this actually appears to be, this last I checked, we had legal installations on the
however,
set. However, it tells me that this product key is invalid.
Uh-oh.
So that's a little squirrely.
However, I'm going to show you in boot camp a serious Windows flaw. I'm not kidding, serious, that the service pack fixes. If you don't fix it, you are running a big, big risk. We'll show you the details in just a couple of minutes on the show, but this is very important. You must watch this, and do download the service pack if you can. I don't know. We're debating whether to tell you. There's another simple way to do this.
You're debating. I'm all in favor.
You say do it?
All
right, I'll do it. I'll show you the simple way. According to a report issued today by the Internal Data Corporation, IDC, PC shipments are expected. What do you think? Up, down? They're going to go up by only 1% over the next year.
That's not down.
It's not down, but it's far below the normal growth rate and certainly previous estimates.
Okay, we've had this huge growth rate for PCs for probably well over a decade or two. It started to slow down 2 or 3 years ago.
People don't need new computers.
But people are still buying a lot of new computers. It's just not growing exponentially every year. How many millions of computers are sold every year?
That's true.
Is that a bad thing?
No.
It's the percentage of cars people drive
the whole
every year
industry,
going up astronomical?
No, of course not. The whole industry is based, though, on those growth rates, right? You understand. I mean, they have all their projections.
At one
Intel's
point,
building,
car industry was voted on that.
That's
change
right.
over time.
Well, the problem is Intel builds these multi-billion dollar fabs based on demand 10 years down the road.
Why
they take look at it and
Intel?
They go, oh, geez, nobody's going to buy a new computer. We're in trouble.
People are buying new computers. Not as many. So therefore, we should feel bad because Intel made bad projections.
I don't feel bad.
You shouldn't feel bad either.
I don't feel bad. That camera will kill you, though. So our question of the day, the New York Times says it's general economic malaise, but I say it's because people are happy they don't need to upgrade. You've got a gigahertz computer. Well, who needs 3 gigahertz? Our question of the day, by the time you get around to buying a new computer, it might not even be a computer. Have you bought your last PC?
Oh, yeah, because we're all going to use email and web browsing appliances.
Xbox for everyone! Cast your vote, yes or no. Microsoft's going to show at Comdex a consumer electronics device that does everything. It's not a computer.
And almost as many people who buy that will, the web TV, all 6 of them that are still
you're
running.
Right. 24 hours to vote. Have you bought your last PC?
No.
Go to screensavers.com.
Except for
I know you haven't. No, I'm never going to buy mine. Every year I buy a new one just to help the industry.
He's a Mac guy
now. I love this, though. And I'll tell you why I'm a Mac guy in a little bit. Okay. Why I'm not telling. You know, I've changed my tune. People ask me, my relatives and friends ask, what should I buy? Mac. I don't tell them Windows anymore, and I'll tell you why in a little bit. On the line from Sacramento, California, it's George. Hey, George.
Hey there, guys.
How are you? Welcome to the show.
Yeah. Hey, it's a hard time getting in.
Yeah, well, you know, it is hard to get in.
Yeah. Anyway.
Price of popularity.
The service pack there. They're saying that they're going to auto-detect on this, or how are they? Because I looked at this and said 133 versus 36 megs.
Yeah.
I just did a bunch of updates.
let me explain what Service Pack is, and Patrick's going to tell you what's going to happen to you, George. A Service Pack, periodically, Microsoft bundles together all the updates they've ever done, all the fixes, everything they've ever thought. It's almost like a new release of the operating system, except they're not charging you for it.
Mm-hmm.
You go online, you download it. It's called a Service Pack because it's a major upgrade. It applies all the patches up to now. a lot of fixes, and in this case, it could be as big as 140 megabytes. I mean, it could be huge, depending on, you know, whether you've updated all along or not. Now, Patrick, what happens? Because you've been doing
it. Well, a couple of, either you can download the giant file, or you can go with what they call the Express. What it does, you download the Express file. It's a 2 megabyte file, the Express installation. It goes through your machine and basically looks to see what updates you need. Now, if we click through this page, after about 30 clicks, I managed to find the categorized list of fixes in Windows XP Service Pack 1.
There's quite a few.
Yeah, we got the updated version of Jet 4.0, cannot print from Windows. You know, there's just lists of stuff and stuff and stuff. This is everything in there.
Holy moly.
Compiled together.
Yeah. I mean, that's kind of a lot of stuff.
Right. Well, the thing is what they're going to do is if you've been installing service, like Leo just said, if you've been installing updates all along, which literally they seem to come out almost every other day. If not
yeah, I usually do them like once a month.
Good,
yeah.
Good.
You're not going to have to download as much stuff. Therefore, it behooves you to use the Express.
He should use the Express.
Right.
Okay. Now, what are they actually separating? They're applying to their stuff. What are they separating from the system? That's my scary point.
Okay. The thing, there's a BBC article that talked about that. What they're separating from the system, as a matter of fact, I'll scroll
separating
down.
Separating from the system.
See, I've been trying to install, sir. I wasn't at home this morning, so I couldn't install some of the system.
It just went online. It's just recently. I mean, it hasn't been online.
But if you look, the BBC is covering an article, and what they're saying is, the idea is that normally you can't make certain things disappear, like Outlook Express, Internet Explorer, Windows Messenger, and Windows Media Player.
They have to sit on the desktop.
Right. There's going to be a control panel. There's going to be a control panel that allows you to make all the appearances of those disappear from the desktop screen, the start menu, and the taskbar. It's like a one-click, get all the Microsoft stuff you don't use out of there.
This
which
is part
I
of the
already
consent
do
decree.
By right-clicking and making it disappear manually. This will automate that process.
It's part of the consent decree. Now, here's the bottom line. Should you apply the service pack, knowing what I know about the security issues in Windows XP, and I just learned this over the weekend.
Now,
You're building up
for a specific security flaw that is just
huge.
One of the many things covered in the service pack. George, there is an uninstall. Basically, it says, do you want to save files so you can reverse, go back, uninstall the service pack one, save, what they call it, archive those files. That way, if you do create problems with your Windows XP system, you uninstall Service Pack 1 and go back to the previous version.
That's happened in the past. Microsoft has released service packs that have totally hosed the operating system.
Yeah.
I've always said, wait a week or two. This is the first time I've ever said, you broke me down. I'm going to show you a fix for this particular flaw. But remember, there are many other flaws that the service pack fixes. There is, in fact, though, in Windows XP, a flaw so horrendous, so devastating, so destructive, that I absolutely think everybody should apply this service pack. I'm going to show you the flaw. I'm actually going to delete some data from my hard drive from going to a website.
Yeah.
I'm going to show you that flaw in just a little bit, and then we'll show you. I will. I'll show them the file that they can rename or delete that will fix this particular flaw. But I think you still should download the service pack because you don't know what else is in there.
and
they're not going
to
tell you.
To find out. Yeah.
Yeah. I'm going to tell you something that the entire security community has been keeping secret for 11 weeks. This is such a serious flaw, they didn't want anybody to know about it, because if people did, we would all be in deep trouble. Coming up in just a bit, you've got something blue to show us.
Something blue. We're going to talk about whether or not Microsoft mice have solved the individual product needs of everyone. The break. Is a virtual woman like Simone technically possible, huh? You're going to find out from a man who, yes, has created his own digital people. When the Screensavers, Scrabblers?
Scrabblers.
The Scrabblers continues.
Be our guest and come see the show in person. If you're going to be in the San Francisco Bay Area and you'd like to join the Screensavers live on the set, go to www.techtv.com/ticketline for information and to request tickets. Go there so we can see you here.
Today, something new will happen. A new idea. A new medicine or a new invention will revolutionize your world. At TechTV, new is what we do every day. Innovative television about new and life-changing technology. From the amazing to the breathtaking. See the world of technology through the eyes of one truly original television network, TechTV. New things. Turn us on.
like a movie theater.
Come to Radio Shack now during the Hollywood in Your Home sale and get an RCA home theater in a box with DVD player for just $299.99. And a two-room RCA DirecTV system is just $29.99 after a $70 Radio Shack mail-in rebate.
There's just one thing that's missing. A cup holder.
Radio Shack. You've got questions, we've got answers.
Hi, Mr. and Mrs. Miller.
How's the vacation planning going, Dad?
Great.
Just the two of us. No kids, no house, no worries.
Change your search without using the back button. Another way Expedia makes it easy to find the trip you're looking for.
Expedia.com.
It has a sleek all-in-one design like the Apple iMac computer, only it's faster, has more storage capacity, and can run thousands more software programs. Presenting the remarkable new Gateway Profile 4. Oh, and by the way, did we mention the Gateway Profile costs less than the iMac?
Ever dream you could fly? You can fly in a lot less time and for a lot less money than you thought.
Americans fly themselves for many important reasons. To visit family.
To take a business trip.
Or get away from the everyday.
To prepare for a career or just for the fun of it.
You can too, and for a lot less than you think.
Flying is part of my active life.
Why not stop dreaming and start flying?
Try flying for $49, 888-BE-A-PILOT, or check out BeAPILOT.com.
Good morning, Simone.
Good morning, Mr. Taransky.
Simone, a star is digitized. Do you know what this means? We have stepped into a new dimension.
In case you didn't see the movie, that was a clip from New Line Cinema's new release, Simone, in which Al Pacino, oh, great actor, creates a virtual woman and fools the world into thinking she actually exists. She's really just him and a computer. But can it be done? Let's ask somebody who actually did something pretty similar via satellite from our Boston Bureau, author, scientist, and amazing fellow, Ray Kurzweil, joining us on the Screensavers. Hi, Ray.
Hi, glad to be here.
Welcome to the show. Have you seen Simone?
I did, yes.
Wasn't a great movie, I hear.
Well, Al Pacino was sort of vintage. He was fun to watch.
I love him, yeah.
Otherwise, the movie was lacking in some cinematic qualities.
Let's ask about the scientific or the technical qualities. Could you do something like that?
Well, this movie suffered from what you see in a lot of science futurism movies, like in the movie AI. They create a, let's add emotion to androids, and the very first version is perfect. And here, let's create a synthetic actor, a synthespian. And the very first version, Simone, is absolutely perfect and takes the world by storm. Now, as you well know, on your program, that's not how technology evolves. And we have synthespians. I mean, I had experience with one project. You can see Final Fantasy, which was synthespians. Very impressive, but not totally convincing. And gradually, the technology will get better and better. Eventually, they will be indistinguishable from people. But by that time, people will be used to the concept, and they won't be surprised by synthespians. So the fact that you'd sort of spring this on the world, and the world would, I mean, nobody in this movie ever asks, is Simone a synthespian?
Right.
It never occurs to them,
right.
Because this first version, out of the blue, is absolutely perfect. That's not realistic.
That's typical Hollywood, though. I wouldn't expect it realistic. It is interesting, though, that you think that such a thing could happen, although down the road, not right away. Tell me about Ramona, because you made a character of your own, right?
Right. About 2 years ago, created very much what you see in the movie, and I actually had Victor Transky's experience, and I did this in front of a conference called TED, Technology and Entertainment Design, and as I moved my hand, Ramona moved her hand, as my mouth moved, her mouth moved, my voice was transformed into her voice, and I was really transformed in real time into this 25-year-old female rock singer from New Orleans.
And incidentally, you look just like Al Pacino while you're doing it.
Well, I don't know about that, but
you look like a young Al Pacino. Hey, let me ask you, because Well, I remember our producer told you about Simone. You hadn't heard about the movie yet. Do you feel like the producers of this movie maybe were at the TED conference, saw you do this, and said, let's make a movie?
Well, there were a lot of people from Hollywood there, so I don't know if the people involved with this movie were there, but it had a lot of exposure to the Hollywood community, and really, well, the purpose of it was to seed the idea, and so I'm glad that it's taken root.
You're not bitter, then?
No, I mean, the purpose was to create influence, so I think we've done that.
Yeah, clearly. And because it looks so much like a scene from the movie, I have to think that they must have been influenced. That how hard was it to do what you did? Now, admittedly, this was a couple of years ago. How hard was it to do what you did with
Well, it was very hard, and that's another sort of unrealistic notion in the movie. I mean, here Victor Transky, who knows nothing about computers, pulls off this live performance of Simone in front of 100,000 live people and a worldwide audience, and he does it with no technical staff at all. I mean, we had 20 people, and it was a very difficult undertaking. It really was pushing the state of the art. Eventually, this will be easy to do, and there will be synthespians, and it's going to be a new form of expression. It still takes people, though, to create the concept. I mean, we have human performers who have a lot of people behind them that are creating the concept, so eventually you won't need a human to be the front person.
Now, I notice you're not wearing a bodysuit when you're doing Ramona. How is Ramona synced to your motion?
Well, I was wearing magnetic sensors
under
my clothing, so as I moved, she moved in exactly the same way. The computer was picking up all of my motion.
For about 18 months, I played a digital synthetic character on MSNBC's The Site called Deb Null. Same thing, wearing the suit like that.
And my voice was actually driving her mouth.
Right.
And my voice was transformed using signal processing into a woman's voice.
So the technology's been around. It's gotten better and better and better. You think when we do a synthespian, it'll still be somebody in a bodysuit, or do you think they can be autonomous?
I think eventually we can pick up motion from a video. So you're watching me now, and as I'm moving, you could actually have some intelligent algorithms that would figure out exactly how I'm moving, perhaps with multiple cameras so that you could resolve ambiguities. And that could be the motion capture, so you don't actually have to wear anything.
How far off is this kind of thing?
Well, we can do pretty good jobs today. There's actually a system where you wear tiny little sensors that are that flash a light, but in a non-visible range. And they have multiple cameras, and you can move around and actually pick up your motion very well. That's pretty much there, although not inexpensive. The real-time synthesis is still pushing the capabilities of our computers. So something like Final Fantasy, which was synthespians, was done in non-real time.
Right.
And there you can do a much better job.
They
still
rendered
didn't
it
have the emotional resonance of a human actor.
No, and it was a flop of a film, I think, because of that. They render that after the fact. It takes a long time for each second of film to be rendered. What you were doing with Ramona and what Al Pacino was doing with Simone and what I did with Dev Null. When I did Dev Null, it required a Silicon Graphics Onyx, a $500,000 computer to do that. Is that the level of computing power we're talking about still?
We used high-end workstations,
yeah. So
it wasn't quite as expensive, but it was pushing the state of the art. We wanted a character that was somewhat photorealistic, not just a cartoon character. So it really was trying to do what you see in the movie Simone.
The lipstick's pretty good. I'm looking at Ramona right now. It's pretty amazing.
I didn't really think about that at the time.
How was that, by the way, for you doing the cross-gender thing? How did that, was that kind of an interesting experience?
Well, it was definitely an interesting experience, and it's actually somewhat liberating to transform yourself into someone else, regardless of who it is, because we have this idea that we are our bodies, and very much our identity is dependent on that. And the fact that you could actually be someone else and express a different personality that I think we all have inside us is quite liberating. So it wasn't a matter of gender confusion on my part. It was just, I think we have other people we'd like to be. And in the future, this will be very easy to do, and people will be able to transform themselves as for entertainment, to relive history, as a homework assignment, as a way of engaging in different kinds of relationships. It will be another modality for expressing ourselves.
Yeah, that's interesting, too. It really is fun. And you're right, it's very liberating and kind of a interesting way. Ray's great books, of course, The Age of Intelligent Machines and Spiritual Machines, and his latest, Are We Spiritual Machines? Wonderful, wonderful reading, really kind of pushing the envelope of where we're going, what will happen down the road. And we also have a full article that Ray wrote about Simone and his experiences with Ramona on our website, thescreensavers.com. And we link to his book on artificial intelligence. Ray, thanks once again for joining us.
My pleasure.
Always a pleasure to talk to you, Ray. Take care. Stay put, folks. Trust me, you're not going to want to miss boot camp. A very important security alert. If you've got Windows XP, you could be in very real danger of losing data. I do have a solution, and I will show you coming up next. Also, Microsoft, actually this coming up later, but coming up next, Microsoft is a software company. They also make hardware now. We're going to take a look at something old, something new, something borrowed, something blue, right after this web tip.
Make your own web page. There are tons of resources on the web. Look for our basic guide to building a web page to learn everything from coding your masterpiece to getting it up on the web.
Mean a thing if it ain't got that swing. Do what, 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 do what. Don't mean a thing if it ain't got that swing. Do what, 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 do what.
Thanks for saving the spot, boys.
From professional grade people to professional grade SUVs.
Fred, who knew one cup of coffee could do that much damage?
Fred. Is a prayer supposed to smoke like that?
Hey, Fred, I think I fried the motherboard and the fatherboard, too.
Dealing with technology is hard. That's why CDW makes buying it as simple as possible, by having brand-name technology products in stock so you can get what you need when you need it.
Fred, where are you going? My email's still down.
CDW, the right technology right away.
Next, please.
Well, hello.
Oh, great. A talking gecko.
Geico. 15 minutes could save you 15% or more on car insurance.
Customer satisfaction is at an all-time high. I don't think we've ever had numbers this high. Mm-hmm. I mean, this guy has really worked his tail off. His tail.
Geico. 15 minutes could save you 15% or more on car insurance.
The critics insisted on a few more. The 340-horsepower Q45 from Infiniti.
That was painful. What the heck?
And it's a special Isaac Hayes edition of the Screensavers.
Oh,
get out your...
You know, baby.
I don't even know where to go with that.
You pull out your blue keyboard.
Actually, it's funny we should get all funky with the opening.
You feel like a man.
The mouse, the common ordinary mouse. Microsoft's been selling mice for like a decade, and they've got a new one. Leo, work a little astral blue into there.
Come on over and move that mouse a little closer to me.
I wish I had the press kit in my hand, right? Because Microsoft, Leo's a good here. The truth is, what you really need to hold that. Now, Microsoft just said one of the problems with mice is
they're beige.
Exactly, and they don't express the individuality that is crucial to the computing experience today. So they came up with a blue mice that answers the need of everyone.
This
Astral
is directly
blue.
From the press kit, it folks. Is, he's not making this
no,
up.
No, I can't. Even I am not that weird. So if you want to be an individual, get a blue keyboard or mouse.
Any color you want, as long as it's blue.
Yeah, isn't that great? Ooh. All right, let's take a step back from this. First
they couldn't
of all,
even change the color of the keyboard. No,
they came out with basically Microsoft. You know, once or twice a year, they throw out their new hardware to the masses, and we make fun of them. Actually, the mice are pretty good. Now, this is very similar.
I like Microsoft's optical mice a lot.
First of all, one of the things Leo likes the most, there is no left or right-handedness to
them
anymore.
It's an agnostic mouse. I call it
hand agnostic. An ambidextrous mouse.
Ambidextrous.
Okay. Second thing, you know something? This doesn't have. This is about $35.
That's a good price.
Yeah, if you can find, actually, it's got a slightly bigger wheel, so it's a slightly thicker wheel. I think it'll make it easier to use.
Does it have the side buttons?
It does not.
See, I like those.
Okay, if you like those, you need to go for the IntelliMouse
Explorer. That's what I have at
which
home.
Is about $50. This one's about $35, which should be even cheaper without, see, I hate the wink buttons. I don't use them.
The side buttons go up, go back a web page or forward a web page. And
well,
like
or whatever
that.
You program
right,
it to.
Right.
That's because you actually take advantage of them.
I use it.
Yeah. I am too old a dog to learn such new tricks as a fourth and ninth button on my mouse. Actually, what's funny is they are actually, it's the other funny thing they said in their press kit is, you know, there are people who like fun stuff, and there are people who like serious stuff, and then there are people who like to have all of the latest crap. You like mice, and for you, and we didn't get this one in, but they have like a 37.
Did they mention me by name?
No, but they have a 37 button mouse, specifically with you in mind. Speaking of, not a bad, actually a pretty good deal, $35. If you don't want the little winglet buttons that Leo likes, not a bad mouse. I've been using one of these on set for years.
Optical's great. Mm-hmm. I would like a wireless optical, and
they make
those as
too,
well.
Which is also, again, it's a big price up.
Price jump.
You know, the wireless ones work better at home than they do in our studio.
That's the truth.
Okay, another one they have. I'm going to toss this one real quick. They also have a notebook mouse. Obviously, they're upset that everybody on the planet is making money off of little tiny mice. Let me show you the size difference between a full-size mouse and the notebook mouse in my hand up here, the silver one.
That's good, though.
It's actually very portable, surprisingly easy to use, part of which is these indents in the side. They did cutaways, so the mouse actually does a pretty graceful job of sitting in your hand, which is something that a lot of the notebook mouse makers have not done. One last product, and this one, to go through, the Microsoft multi-key keyboard. And some people seem to love, first of all, I'm going to point out, this thing is huge with the wrist rest, right? We're going to slide that out. Are you still coding up things to kill people's systems with Leo?
Sorry.
Like every other multimedia keyboard in the planet, they've got an array of keys up on top. What do? They launch, your media player, volume button, skip forward, skip
back. I have
that,
and I use that to mute the sound real quick, mm-hmm. things like that, which is very handy.
I'll be honest with you. There's two things I was surprised. One, I installed it on a Windows system, and it actually, when I hit the media player, it launched Winamp, which is my preferred media player, so it's not going only to Microsoft stuff. That's a good thing. Two, I think the calculator keyboard,
I use the calculator button.
Thank you. The calculator button is probably the most useful thing on here.
That's very handy. I use
that. One of us can say that. Launches your home page.
Now, you can reassign that to any. It doesn't have to be the Windows calculator.
Exactly. But what we did notice is something. I ran this on a 98 system. When you go to launch something like My Music,
which is not existing on My Music.
Exactly. You can't reassign it to whatever folder your MP3s, your other media files are in.
That's a shame.
Very irritating. No, it is programmable. You can launch other things. You can do commands with it. But it would seem that would be an obvious one. A couple last things. They've raised the buttons down on here, the control, the Alt, the Start, the Windows key, make them a little easier to see. They did a rearrange the 104 keyboard.
Now that's a
really
big
irritating
change.
If you're used to a 104 keyboard and you use the Home and the End and the Page and the Insert key, they're moved around and the Insert key is gone. That may be great for casual users. Experts are going to find it annoying. And you know what else I found annoying? They changed the F keys up top to traditional Microsoft, I believe it's traditional Microsoft assignments, so Help, Undo. You can lock that in place with a key down here and use those instead of traditional shortcuts. Which, one last thing before we go, they actually did put out props on the front of these keys for people who don't know their control shortcuts. If you look at the front of the keys, they actually list them down there, which is kind of nice to add on. I'm mixed about this one. $35, not bad. Decent tactile sense. Irritating keyboard outlet that's been changed. And to be honest with you, I've yet to meet one of these keyboards that I actually used on a regular basis.
Right. Yeah. I have an older Intella Pro key. I can't remember the name of it, but Intella Super Duper button doohickey. But I use it, but it's not blue, so I've got to run out and get that.
Because you're an individual.
Yes.
This is like living in the East Village. You're going to be hip. You're going to be an individual because you wear a black leather jacket. You hear what I'm saying, folks? Nonetheless, still available in the beige mouse, still a great mouse, and if you don't want the extra two buttons, you can save $15 or $20.
Do you pay more for the blue?
You don't pay, maybe a dollar or two.
Okay, because blue dye can be expensive.
Well, that's why I want to find, what I'm trying to find is they have one listed, the wheel mouse, which is essentially this mouse without the blue.
Yeah.
And I think you can probably find that for $20, $25, which would be an even better deal.
Yeah, if you don't care about the blue, or just paint it. Get your magic markers, color it in.
Yoshi, it's time for a mod. Spray that mouse. Yoshi's in the back going, what?
He's an individual. He'd
Yoshi
make it will green.
Do any color you want.
That's right.
So, you know what?
I like
Go to
the
screensavers.com. We got a list of all the interesting tidbits I uncovered when I was beating on these.
Folks, don't go anywhere. If you've got Windows XP, you got to stay tuned for boot camp, which is coming up next. I'm going to show you a very serious security flaw, why you must run and download the service pack ASAP. And actually, I'm going to download it and show you what the install looks like, too. When we return, stay right here.
The world's most powerful So, Vanessa, like my new phone? Sleek, huh?
Yeah, Ving, it's different.
All the latest features and big buttons.
Yeah, Ving, but don't you think it's kind of...
Did I mention big buttons?
He loves his big phone, and you'll love our big Motorola deal. Get this Motorola phone, an FM headset, car power adapter, faceplate, and a cool NFL chair for just $59.96 with activation. That's $189 value, just in time for football season. Exclusively at Radio Shack.
This is your own personal assembly line, where deals are made just for you. Like this week's special, the Compact Presario 6000 TPC. It's got an Intel Pentium 4 processor that delivers performance where you need it most. You'll also get a monitor, built-in networking card, and right now, a free CD burner or DVD upgrade. And it's just $799. So call 1-800-332-1780, and we'll line one up for you.
Just follow it up. Where'd the ball go? Where'd the ball go? Where'd the ball go? No. Bring the dog. Bring the ball back.
Meet brains. Genius.
I always knew my theory was correct.
Inventor.
You say everything is completely automatic.
The brains behind it all. This perfectionist is always ready for action, laughing in the face of danger. He's International Rescue's whiz kid, Brains. See him in action on the Thunderbirds. Weekdays at 6:30 Eastern, 3:30 Pacific. Only on TechTV. Tonight on TechTV, radicals.
Yes, we have a soul, but it's made of lots of tiny robots.
Futurists.
We forecast the VCR before anybody had ever seen a VCR.
Innovators.
This is Dolly.
Meet the most fascinating minds of our time on Big Thinkers. Tonight at 9, 8 Central, only on TechTV.
Hello, welcome back to the Screensavers. I'm Leo Laporte. Coming up in this half hour, you need rechargeable batteries to power your gadgets, your cameras, your MP3 players. We got some good deals for you. I'm going to talk a little bit about rechargeables and why they're perfectly fine and good to use and save the environment and work well with those devices. Plus, find out and what devices you shouldn't use them with, too, by the way. Find out from Megan if Eudora, the new one, version 5.1.1, is worth downloading. She's got a mini review for you. Right now, though, time for boot camp. Basic training for your personal confuser. And I normally will take a call and give you a tip on boot camp. Not today, because this is there's such a severe issue with Windows. I really want to talk about it and encourage everybody to patch their system. This is a bug that Microsoft's known about for 11 weeks. It appeared about 3 weeks ago on all the security mailing lists, and I'm sure many people know about it, although an interesting thing has happened. Security experts all over the country have agreed, apparently, not to say anything about it. It's such a serious flaw, they're afraid if they talk about it, hackers will do all sorts of terrible things to people's computers before Microsoft could put out a fix. So we've gone along with that. Microsoft has now put out the fix. And that fixes Service Pack 1. So I want to encourage everybody to download Service Pack 1. But let me show you the problem so you understand the importance, why it's so very important that you download Service Pack 1. Turns out Microsoft put this in all versions of XP. Everybody who's running XP has this vulnerability. It's a vulnerability that's part of Microsoft's help feature. And it allows a website, a malicious website, or even an emailer, to put a link on a web page that if you were to click that link could arbitrarily delete files from your system. It could wipe out your entire Windows directory, for instance, or your documents directory. It's even possible to put this in an email, an HTML email, and have it without you doing anything. You don't have to open an attachment, just by virtue of the fact that you look at the email, delete the same files. I'm going to show you how it works right now. I've created a test version of this on my website. And I've created, in order to demonstrate it, instead of deleting the Windows directory here, I've created a folder called Bug Test on this system. And I've just put a couple of files in there. Now, I'm going to go to a website here, my own website, as a matter of fact, where I've created a web page that demonstrates this flaw. When I click on this link, it will delete the files in bug test. Now understand, I am on a website. Any website could do this, and they could delete it, files from any folder. I'm going to click on that link right now. Here's what happens. It launches the Help and Support Center. Doesn't matter if you say, no, I'm closing the Help and Support. I don't, what? What? I didn't want the Help and Support. Let me just close that, get that out of the way. Let's go back to our C directory and see what happened to the files in bug test. They're gone. Let me put them back in. Let's try that again. That must have been a mistake. Let me click on this. You know, instead of closing that window, I'm going to bomb out of it. I'm going to do a Control-Alt-Delete and kill the process, because obviously that process is dangerous. End that task. I don't want that task. Let's go back. Let's go back now to bug test. See if it fixed it. See, just by killing, bombing out of that task, actually the hidden files are still there, but the other files were deleted. They were still deleted. That's, by the way, important that some of those files did get preserved. Not all the files were deleted, just the non-hidden files. All right, now, well, I want to see if this is going to... That's a very serious flaw. It means if you're running Windows XP and a hacker knows how to do it, I have not yet told you how to do it. If a hacker knows how to do it, you don't have to click on a link. Merely by going to a web page, he can do that. What if he says, instead of bug test, what if he says C:\Windows? Could he delete the... I don't know. Let's try it. I am going to go to Chris Perillo's computer to try this. Let's cancel out of this here. Okay. And I'm going to go to this a special link I made. Again, this is on Leoville. Can you go away from the website? I don't want to show anybody this URL because it is so dangerous. I'm gonna close my address bar. Now you can't see it. Okay, you can show the screen again. Now, in theory, if I click on this, it's going to delete the contents of the Windows directory. You could see how dangerous this would be. And even if I close out on this, it is now, I believe, deleting the contents of my Windows directory. Maybe that the Windows directory is protected. No, it did. It deleted everything in there except for the hidden files. So now if I shut this computer down, it won't restart. I'll have to reinstall Windows. It's actually hosed this system. I'm sorry, Chris. All the files are deleted except for some key hidden files. Everything else has been deleted from the Windows directory. So let's tell you how you can fix that, shall we? I'm going to go back to this other computer. The best way to fix it, I want to encourage everybody to do this, is to download Service Pack 1. Very simple. You run Windows Update. It's as simple as can be. It's going to say, scan for updates, and it's going to tell you, yes, you need Windows Service Pack 1, and apply it. That will fix the problem. Now, here's what the security experts have not told you. And actually, they've asked me not to tell you as well. And I spent a lot of time thinking about this, agonizing about this, and talking to my friends and coworkers about whether I should tell you this, because by telling you what I'm about to tell you, a smart hacker could use that information to create web pages that do what I just did. It's very easy to do. But the reason I'm going to tell you this is because this is such a huge download, and it can mess with your system so much. I know you're not going to all want to do this. There is a file in your system. If you rename or delete that file, this completely protects you from this flaw, okay? And the file is UPDDRV. Oh, I can't even remember it now. Something. Let's just search for those. .htm. Oh, where is it? Mac. And I have to find it in. It's going to be in the Windows directory. If you rename that file or delete it, I have to find it. Maybe it's not here. No. I'll find it. I'm just going to go right into Windows and delete it. It is you. Uh-oh, here comes the security guys. They're going to stop me. They're going to stop me from doing it. It's, what was it? I can't, UPDDRVIN. I can't remember it. Oh. Well, you know, I could just look at my page. Hold on a second. I'll tell you right now. UPLDRVinfo.htm. There it is. Let me do a search again for that. I was asked not to give you this, and I just think that, I don't know, Patrick and I talked about this. Why do you think it's so important that we tell people this?
Well, one, a lot of people aren't going to be able to download Security Patch. Anybody with a questionable update
or a questionable serial number, which we're uncovering a couple on our set right now, are not
going to be able to download the
security patch.
Right.
The biggest thing is that, look, by deleting this file, you can protect yourself from an unbelievable security flaw in a matter of seconds versus the process of downloading a 33 to 160 megabyte service pack. The biggest thing is, you know what, a lot of folks out there, we know you're on dial-up. We know you don't have access
to
broadband.
It's a big thing to download.
And the service pack is huge, and it may take you a while to download it. So go ahead. We're going to give you the information for this to take care of this file in your system and do it now.
We're going to put this information in the show notes so that you can find it. There it is. So it's in the PC. That's why. It's in the PC health directory. updrvinfo.htm. If you merely rename that to say .old or something else, now that's disabled, that capability, and I can no longer delete the files in my Windows directory. Nobody can on the web page. By telling people that, we're giving them information that might make it possible for them to figure out how to do this, how to do the bad thing. But I think it's more important that you know how to fix this for yourself without downloading a 143 megabyte update. And now that the word is out, I don't think it's going to take very long for other companies, other news organizations to be telling you this. So I think it's important for us to tell you. The file name again is updrvinfo.htm. Just rename it or delete it, and that will fix this flaw. However, as we said at the beginning of the show, there may be other flaws that we don't know about. There probably, in fact, almost undoubtedly are. And the Service Pack 1 is the best way to protect yourself. So even if you do this short-term fixed, you know, if you can't download the Service Pack now, do download it as soon as you possibly can. As you can see, it's trivially easy for a web page or an email to delete files on your hard drive. So do download that Service Pack 1. UPLD, as in upload, DRVINFO.htm. Find it, delete it, rename it, and that will fix the problem. Okay, folks, stay where you are. Martin's going to come up and attempt to take up cyber golf. This should be fun to watch. And up next is the real deal, our look at the Sunday newspaper tech ads. That's coming up when the Screensavers continue. Stay right here.
We're talking about the ultimate theory of space and time.
Revolutionary ideas.
The idea of evolution was regarded as highly unorthodox.
Tech TV will take you further than you ever expected.
We have to take risks.
With new shows coming this fall. Tech TV. New things. Turn us on.
Better way to check out phones. At Best Buy, we've got the brands and plans you want, even the latest like Virgin Mobile and PCS Vision from Sprint. Best Buy. Go ahead, turn on the fun.
Research groups at educational institutions play a vital role in advancing biotechnology, but they often operate on razor-thin budgets.
The Buffalo Center of Excellence in Bioinformatics at the University at Buffalo in New York is one of many research teams turning to Dell high-performance computing clusters as a cost-effective alternative to proprietary Unix systems and mainframes.
With the sequencing of the human genome, one has a tremendous opportunity to treat many, many types of disease and ultimately to usher in the age of personalized medicine. The price performance that we've been able to achieve through a partnership with Dell is exceptional. It will enable us to basically do the human genome calculation within 1 year as opposed to 1,000 years.
To meet the University at Buffalo's requirements, Dell developed a single Linux cluster of more than 2,000 dual-processor Dell PowerEdge servers with more than 4,000 Intel Xeon and Pentium 3 processors. The cluster connects to a 16-terabyte Dell EMC storage area network and is backed by Dell's enterprise support services.
At Dell, we're proud to have developed a cost-effective solution that contributes to this valuable research. Dell high-performance computing cluster solutions with Intel processors aren't just for educational institutions. This is a superb value-driven alternative for many other markets, including financial and manufacturing industries. They can offer a long list of advantages over traditional systems, including scalability, availability, and reusability.
For more information about Dell's high-performance computing clusters, call or visit Dell's website at dell.com/HPCC.
You know, we hadn't had the nerve to try that on a Windows machine because we knew we would hose it. And Billy from Call for Help built us a special machine that he said it's okay if you crash it. We did run it on the Windows directory, and interestingly enough, it does not delete files in the Windows directory.
Well,
so
does
those are
not,
protected.
Well, the machine restarted. We don't know.
It's restarting okay, though, right, Billy? Yeah. I think it did not, in fact, damage any files in the Windows directory, which is encouraging. At least you can't completely destroy somebody's Windows directory.
Right.
It doesn't
just
mean you
destroy
can't destroy their My Documents.
Their applications.
Yeah. So.
Their MP3 collection.
Yeah. You'd have to know the folder that they put that stuff in, but and most
My
people
music.
Put it in pretty standard places. Anyway, that's enough on that one. Let's move on. We're going to talk Sunday papers.
You get a newspaper, you notice. You know the drill, folks. Advertisements, Sunday papers, little catalogs, all sorts of stuff like that. Tech products everywhere, DVD
it's
players,
amazing.
Computers, software, memory, dogs, cats.
Even Sears, Target, you know, Office Depot, they all sell hardware.
Target, pardon me.
Yeah. So good deals, not so good deals, and some are, quite frankly, scams.
Well, we like to do this every Monday. We go through the papers and we find some stories, some bargains, some not such good bargains, things that caught our eye. Let's take a look at a couple right now. This is one that's a personal favorite
of
mine.
Let me circle
it for you. Would you circle the nickel metal hydride batteries?
Leo loves these things.
These are not your dad's, your grandfather's rechargeables. If you used NiCad, you probably got pretty dissatisfied with
the whopping hour and 15 minutes of battery life in
terrible.
My MP3 player.
Yeah. Plus, they would wear out real quickly. There's a memory effect and so forth. Nickel metal hydride is much improved.
Really?
You get a lot of juice out of them. They last a long time. They're a very economical solution. And they are not ideal because they leak. The charge is dissipated over a period of time, unlike alkaline batteries, which can last for years. Nickel metal hydride, you'll lose a charge in a couple of months.
So as soon as you take them out of the charger, they start running down.
Right. So bad for things like flashlights. Don't put them in your emergency flashlight, kids. Bad for remote controls. Great for something that you change the batteries a lot, digital
MP3
cameras
players.
Or MP3 players. Couldn't be better. I use it in my Rio. I use it in my Olympus.
How many hours do you get out of your Rio with that?
Pretty much the same. It's
okay.
A little bit less. You put them in, you notice that the battery charger indicator doesn't go all the way up. That's an indicator, although they're getting more and more higher and higher voltage on these so that they do have longer life.
Okay.
The point is they're cheap, especially if you consider how much you spend on batteries. They're good for the landfill and
that's
they work.
That's the big one. They're good for the environment because people don't realize how many batteries end up in landfills every day.
I'm really, this is just an example. One of the stores, they're selling a charger and four batteries. These are double A's for $19.95, and then additional four more batteries for $2.50 per battery. I've seen even lower prices online.
And a lot of people pay $1 a double A battery if they buy them in small, two packs and four max. This will pay for itself in a very short period
Thomas
of time.
Distributing sells them online. These are the rechargeables for a couple of bucks less, maybe even $1.50. So it's not much more than buying a standard AA battery, but you can reuse it over and over again.
That's a good thing.
It makes me feel really good to use these. If you've used rechargeables and been unhappy, try the new nickel metal hydride. Many stores are selling them now, and it really is good for the environment. Well, yours, your turn.
I don't know. I think it's may have been yours, too. Nickel metal hydride cameras. No, 4-megapixel camera. We got the Olympus Commedia. And the question is, if you have a good camera you're satisfied, like a 2-megapixel camera, do you need to move up? What do you get?
That was my question for Patrick. Look at the price on this. $500, which is half what a good high-end camera would have cost you even a year ago.
Yeah, it's a little frightening to watch. My 1-megapixel camera, my Epson that I got almost four years ago now, was like an $800 camera, and now you can get the equivalent in a $50
camera. Does anybody need 4 megapixels? Is that should
the
you go?
The biggest thing, if you're creating files for a website, if you're squashing them into JPEGs, if you normally display them on a smaller site, probably not.
But if you're a serious photographic enthusiast, or if you plan on printing out big size images, 8x10, stuff like that, that's when the extra resolution really starts to, you know, come in play.
If, like me, you have a 3-megapixel camera, I wouldn't feel any urgency to upgrade.
No.
Even a 2-megapixel camera.
2 megapixels on the edge, because a lot of the good early 2-megapixel cameras have been improvements in the, actually, what gets interesting is the hardware that captures the image, that compresses and processes it.
Even the speed of the shutter click, because these cameras have more RAM than the old ones.
There's something worse than going click, flash, and then sitting and staring at the back of the camera for 30 seconds.
Newer cameras are a lot better in many, many ways. However, you don't need to go to 4 megapixels just because you need the megapixels.
Yeah. Unless, you know, your neighbor has a 3-megapixel camera and you want to have a 4-megapixel camera.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
Go to screensavers.com, click on the show notes, see the ads we took a look at along with our scintillating commentary.
Yeah, and if you've got any suggestions for things you'd like to know more about, if you've got ads that you're reading and say, what does that mean? Send us an email, let us know, because we'd love to cover that particular topic.
Right.
Now, folks, it's time to check in with Marty. It's Sight of the Night time.
I know this may come as a shock to some of you, but in high school, I wasn't so good at football or basketball or hockey or other sports involving sticks, balls, rackets, nets, fields, or legs. I did, however, make the junior varsity miniature golf team, and Cindy Habib, if you still have my miniature golf JV Letterman's jacket, I'd like it back. I think you could start talking to me again. That party was a long time ago, and everyone was kind of screwed up. Anyway, my skill at miniature golf in the real world may explain why I'm such a dynamo at this mini golf game that you can find at electrotank.com. Now, if you weren't on the mini golf team in high school, here are the rules. Get the ball in the hole in as few shots as possible. Here we go. That's not a bad shot right there. Ooh, that's looking cherry. Bank it, baby. Man, I would have made varsity if it wasn't for that windmill injury. Man, I still got it. Now, those are some wild days. Let me give a shout out to my old mini golf crew. 1, 2, 3, putt. And Coach Johnson, we learned a lot together, didn't we, man? Hey, you got any Sight of the Night suggestions? Why don't you send them to me? It's martin@techtv.com. Get out there. Back to you, Leo.
I do not want to know what you and Coach Johnson learned together. After the break, learn how to delete Outlook Express forever after this Windows 10.
If you want to select all the files or text, try Control A. It's a shortcut to select everything.
In 1935, Foxwood Farm started with one horse and a truck. The horse was a thoroughbred, the truck a Chevy Suburban. Today they have a few more horses, but there's still only one truck, Chevy Suburban. With an available 8.1-liter Vortec engine, it's capable of towing up to 6 tons, making it the best Suburban yet. Chevy Suburban, like a rock.
Hi, Mr. and Mrs. Miller.
How's the vacation planning going, Dad?
Great.
Just the two of us. No kids, no house, no worries.
Change your search without using the back button. Another way Expedia makes it easy to find the trip you're looking for.
Expedia.com.
Howie, have a seat. Listen.
It's just like a movie theater.
Come to Radio Shack now during the Hollywood in Your Home sale and get an RCA home theater in a box with DVD player for just $299.99. And a two-room RCA DirecTV system is just $29.99 after a $70 Radio Shack mail-in rebate.
There's just one thing that's missing. A cup holder.
Radio Shack. You've got questions, we've got answers.
It has a legendary reputation for reliability, durability, and quality. It's been named to Car and Driver's 10 Best list 16 times. It was the first gasoline-powered production automobile to be certified as a low-emission vehicle in the U.S. And the best part is, it's used.
Proof that how you start out in life is a good indication of how far you'll go. For a limited time, get special APR financing as low as 5.9% for up to 60 months on all Honda-certified used cars.
What the?
What? Hey, I just want you to know, I haven't plugged my book, Leo Laporte's 2003 Technology Almanac, once today.
How much does that cost?
At Amazon.com.
And where can you buy it?
It's there. It's, I don't know. Amazon's charging like 18 bucks for it.
Okay.
25 bucks.
Amazon.com?
Yeah, or Barnes & Noble.
You
know what's great
one.
This year? That all the bookstores really are carrying. I finally saw a copy of it for the first time today. It's beautiful.
Did you sign it?
I did. I
in the store.
It.
So somewhere in the San Francisco, Marin County area.
Actually, I may have driven anywhere in the United States. So go to your store now. Could have been anywhere. Or go to Amazon.com or leoville.com/book. Or
you know what? If you go to Amazon.com and it gets number one, Leo will stop mentioning the book.
That's
on
all
air.
I ask. I won't plug it.
Didn't that feel good?
I won't plug it anymore.
Sean joins us on the phone from Edwardsville, Illinois.
Hey, Sean.
Hey, guys. What's going on?
Well, just hanging out, doing our thing.
Cool.
What's up with you?
Nothing too much.
No. Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Chilling?
Yep.
Chilling.
Hanging.
Yeah.
Yep.
I was just wondering if there was any way that I could make a folder in Outlook Express and have all my TechTV newsletters go straight to that folder instead of going to the inbox.
Wouldn't that be a good idea? That'd then it wouldn't clutter up your inbox.
Yeah.
Because you get a new one. You know, we send out the Screensavers newsletter every darn day.
Yep.
You know,
I could look
and
at
you love it? Do you like it, Sean?
Sure do.
Because it's really, you know, it's basically a labor of love for us here. We put our heart and souls into that newsletter. So I'm so glad that you subscribed to it. It's easy to get. Just go to thescreensavers.com. There's a subscription link. Now, here's what, it's very easy to make a filter for it. What you want to look at is what makes that email unique. This is true. I'm going to give you kind of the general rule. Is it, in your case, it's probably not the sender, but the recipient. Probably, I can't remember what it is, but probably says something like Screensavers mailing list at techtv.com. Now, that's unique. Of all the mail you get, the only mail you get that's addressed to that address is the stuff you get from us, because everything else is addressed to Sean.
Right.
And that's true of many mailing lists. So very often when you want to filter mailing lists, you should do it based on the recipient address. And I don't want to launch Instant Messenger. I want to launch Outlook. So this is an Outlook Express. You said Outlook Express?
Yeah.
All right, let me do Outlook Express so we can. I can never remember MSSISSIPPI, right? MSISM.
MSINM.
INM. That's it. MSINM. Thank you, Mark. MS, what is it?
I-M-N.
There it is. Gosh, you guys are good.
Behind every highly public television show host are a whole slew of hardworking women helping make sure he looks good.
I think it's age, actually. I think I'm losing my mind. So let's go to tools. Seriously, I'm not kidding. I used to remember this stuff easily. Message rules. Now, in this case, you're going to say where the to line, and actually don't do people because that will look for somebody in your address book. You want to actually say
message from the specified.
Where the to contains people, no. Where the message, I guess you have to do that. Where the to line contains people, and then, you know, boy.
You could look for specific words.
Yeah, you know, I don't like it that you have to do that. You'd have to actually add an address book entry. They've changed Outlook Express. So I can't remember what it is. What is it, tech? Is it Screensavers, show notes, something like this. Whatever the address is, okay? And then add that to it. And then once you do that, when it says where the to line contains that, then you say move it to the specified folder. And I'm going to create a new folder that says show notes. And there's show notes. I'm going to click it and say okay. Now I've created a rule.
You could also do that with the specific words in the subject line.
Well, and that's the key on making filters is look for the thing that makes that message unique from all the other messages you receive. Mm-hmm. You could do it on the from line, but what if, you know, we sent a message specifically to you, Sean, you wouldn't want to filter that.
Wouldn't want to miss it.
Yeah, or the subject line may not always say the same thing. So it's good to pick the thing that was going to be the most consistent and unique to that message and then just create the filter like that, and that's all there is to it. It will now, from now on, every time a message comes that's addressed to that address, it'll go in that folder.
Hoo-ha.
That's a very useful skill. If you know how to filter email, you can organize your life.
Or you could never read another email you don't want to read again.
I like that. Let's get the download of the day, shall we?
Long, long ago, on a Macintosh far, far away, I used to use an email program called Eudora.
but at some point I switched to Outlook Express. Why? I have no idea. Why do I do anything? So recently my Outlook Express has been crashing like crazy. So I thought, why not go back to the tried and true? So I'm back to Eudora, the newest version 5.1.1, and here's what I like about it. Let's take a look. First of all, there is better virus protection. I believe this right here is actually a virus. And if I had gotten it in Outlook Express, it might have been able to script itself right through there. But Eudora has no scripting capabilities, so you will not get those viruses. Also, very easy to import from Outlook Express. Our last caller, the filters are a lot easier too. You know, Leo was having some trouble because he doesn't use Outlook Express much anymore either. So just click to import, click File, Import, and you can see I got Kat's email, mine. I think I'll convert Kat over to Eudora too. She's not here today, so. And another really great thing is works with OS 10, OS 9, OS 8 for Mac, and of course Windows. And one more thing I want to show you, the statistics. This is very cool. If you go to Tools and Statistics, you can see how many emails you've received today, how many yesterday. You can do your statistics for a year. You can actually see how many you read, how many you responded to, and how many attachments you sent. It's very cool stuff, all available at Eudora. And the link is at the screensavers.com, or I think it's qualcomm.com. That is where the product is actually from. Now back to you, boys.
Yes, I love that. I used that product for many, many years.
Yes.
And it's much safer than Outlook or Outlook Express. Mm-hmm. Stay where you are, folks. Still to come on this very show, you asked about buying a new monitor. Pat and I will fight it out over the LCD versus the CRT issue. Al Michaels and Melissa Stark, da-da-da-da, kick off Monday Night Football with sports and tech. And Marty reveals the truth about Leonard Nimoy. Finally, someone willing to tell the truth as the Screensavers rolls on.
Mean a thing if it ain't got that swing. Do what, 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 do what. Don't mean a thing if it ain't got that swing. Do what, 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 do what.
Thanks for saving the spot, boys.
From professional grade people to professional grade SUVs.
I am Voltazoid. I will destroy you with my plasma ray.
You are wrong, Zoid. Your ray is no match for Lord Gorlok.
Excuse me? Did you know that Geico settles many car insurance claims in 48 hours or less?
Geico. 15 minutes could save you 15% or more on car insurance.
Impressive, Green One.
Tell you all the features of the new Infiniti G35. But hey, who has time to watch a 14-minute commercial? The new G35 from Infiniti.
Hey, want to heat up your summer? Turn us on. TechTV. New shows, new stars, and a whole new perspective all summer long. It's a schoolyard showdown, a virtual hoedown. It's visionaries and X-ray vision. It's solar power, it's brain power. It's live health on the line. It's driving on a dime. It's an all-terrain, code-cracking, fabulous, flying, futuristic funhouse. It's Tech TV. Why should you watch cybercrime on Tech TV? Well, what do you have to lose?
I think my total loss was in the $60,000 range.
I went through all my husband's insurance money.
Every week, cybercrime explores the dark side of technology. From personal privacy to online scams. From identity theft to adult content. Cybercrime exposes the hot topics you need to know and won't see anywhere else. Watch cybercrime. Tuesdays at 9, 8 Central on Tech TV.
Adventure has a new name. Tech TV presents The Thunderbirds. Dazzling special effects. Non-stop action.
Holy mackerel.
And adventure.
If lives depend upon it, then we must risk it.
When danger calls, The Thunderbirds blast off to the rescue. Watch Thunderbirds weekdays at 6:30 Eastern, 3:30 Pacific, only on Tech TV.
Welcome back to the Screensavers. I'm rock and rolling Leo Laporte.
And I'm just Patrick Norton. But I'm glad you joined us tonight. This is our temporary set. They've loaned it.
Oh, yeah.
To us from TechLive. Very kind of them. Construction is going on next door to us with screaming power tools as we speak.
It was cool. I went over there. Did you go over there?
Big arches.
Oh, wait till you see the new set. 2 weeks from now. 2 weeks from today. Hey, could you keep it down?
Coming up in this half hour.
Yes, fabulous stuff. Sportscasters Melissa Stark and Al Michaels from ABC's Monday Night Football will give us the sneak peek at the Madden 2003 game. And
That's what they're doing.
Yeah. And Martin explains why Leonard Nimoy has a restraining order against him. You would too if you knew Marty.
I don't need restraining orders.
Yeah, you have a sledgehammer. Let's check in with the great folks over at Tech Live, see what's coming up tonight. Erica Hill joins us from the Tech Live set. Hi, Erica.
Hello, gentlemen. Leo, you got the spiffy rock star shoes on today.
I do. Thank you. Thanks for noticing.
All aflame. I hope that's not because the odor is so strong.
Yeah, they're on fire. We got a fungus among us.
Okay, so moving on, leaving the fungus behind, let's talk about what's coming up on Tech Live. Big day. Using tracking devices to give medical staff an instant way to communicate probably sounds like a pretty darn good idea. But nurses and other hospital employees have other things on their mind. They're questioning the health and privacy effects of wearing such a device for 8 hours or more a day. It's a debate about patient care and privacy concerns coming up tonight on Tech Live as we look at both sides of the day. Plus, we all know how vital communication is for emergency crews when responding to a disaster. Coming up tonight on Tech Live, we'll see just how far communication advances have come this past year and what firefighters can expect to be working with when there's a life and death situation. That's all coming up this evening, 8:30 Eastern, right here on Tech Live, following the smelly screensaver.
Hey!
Just kidding. Patrick, you don't smell.
No.
But Leo, whew!
Leo puts the fun in fungus.
Oh, I shouldn't do that. I'm sorry. Thank you very much, Erica Hill. That's what's coming up on Tech Live tonight. So PC sales. Bam, zoom. They're not going to grow anywhere near the way they've grown in the past.
Wait, the economy's in a dumper, but PC sales have only grown 1.1%. Ergo, the PC industry is hosed.
Yeah.
Well, what are you, major news guy now?
No, the whole...
That's how they make those assumptions.
The whole industry is based on the growth rates, the go-go growth rates of the last 10
they
years.
They haven't been go-go growth rates for 3 or 4 years. Anyhow, you know what?
It's not growing very fast.
The question comes down to...
It's, let's say, essentially flat.
Right.
So people are not buying them as
They're only
much.
Buying millions of PCs every year.
Right. So our question of the day, I personally have the opinion that's because today's computers are fast enough. You're not going to buy another computer for a while. By the time you come to the market, they're going to be something else, like Xboxes or something. Have you bought your last PC? Patrick says, not a chance. I say maybe. Go to the screensavers.com and cast your vote. What do you think? It'd be 98%?
It should have been yes, no, or I'm going to buy an Apple next.
We should mean PC is computer. Yeah. Apple included. In
you're going to buy another Apple. Up next,
absolutely.
Martin goes in search of Leonard Nimoy. When the screensavers continue.
Does he find him? Find out.
Excuse me.
Like my new phone? Sleek, huh?
Yeah, Ving, it's different.
All the latest features and big buttons.
Yeah, Ving, but don't you think it's kind of...
Did I mention big buttons?
He loves his big phone, and you'll love our big Motorola deal. Get this Motorola phone, an FM headset, car power adapter, faceplate, and a cool NFL chair for just $59.96 with activation. That's $189 value, just in time for football season. Exclusively at Radio Shack.
With their incredible power, sleek design, and affordable prices, Gateway's new computers are a great value. But now they're a better value than ever, because right now, you can get free shipping with the purchase of select Gateway desktops. Call 1-800-GATEWAY for details.
This is an IT industry alert.
Getting certified as an IT professional will give you job security and greatly increase your salary. And with Smart Certifies, fast and easy IT certification courses, now it can happen for you. Choose from Microsoft MCSE, Cisco Certification, A-Plus Technician, Certified Internet Webmaster, and a variety of other hot IT courses, including introductory computer courses. Smart Certifies self-paced courses give you content developed with industry leaders, 24-hour online mentoring, practice exams, and hands-on skill-building simulations, all with a money-back certification guarantee. Call Smart Certify Direct today, toll-free at 1-877-TRAINING and get IT certified guaranteed. Or try a course free at www.smartcertifieddirect.com. Call today.
Is there really anything new on television? At TechTV, new is what we do every day.
What you'll be playing very soon.
With television that entertains.
Max Pedro.
Thunderbirds are go.
Enlightens.
Think about that.
And brings out the creative genius in all of us. See the amazing, breathtaking world of technology through the eyes of one truly original television network. TechTV. New things. Turn us on.
My life, I've had one overriding dream: to sip an iced tea in a shady patio setting with Leonard Nimoy. So after years of talking about it and thousands of unanswered emails, I decided to go right up to Leonard Nimoy's house. Excuse me.
Yes.
Is Leonard Nimoy on the premises?
I wouldn't tell you.
Okay, will you just tell him that Martin from the Screensavers stopped by? Thanks, man. So even though talking to Leonard Nimoy's gardener was the thrill of a lifetime and a way to impress chicks at Star Trek conventions, I wasn't fulfilled. So I decided to try the next best thing, to search for Leonard Nimoy on the internet. And here are the five most curious things I found out about my boy, Leonard Nimoy. Number five. Of course, in addition to Star Trek, I'm like the world's biggest Lord of the Rings fan. So it was a huge pleasure to learn that in the late 1970s, Leonard Nimoy sang a song called The Ballad of Bilbo Baggins. Roll it!
In the middle of the earth, in the land of Shire, lives a brave little hobbit whom we all admire. With his long wooden pipe, fuzzy woolly toes, he lives in a hobbit hole and everybody knows him. Bilbo, Bilbo Baggins, it's only 3 feet tall.
That is awesome, man! That's awesome! Man, if he also played Dungeons & Dragons, he'd be the coolest guy in the world. Number four, want some more spicy Leonard Nimoy info? Well, it turns out there's an international think tank called the Leonard Nimoy Should Eat More Salsa Foundation. The idea here is that Leonard Nimoy is excellent and salsa is excellent, so if Leonard Nimoy ate more salsa, he'd be an unstoppable source of excellence. Now here's the Leonard Nimoy Should Eat More Salsa game, and here is the Leonard Nimoy Pong game, in which Leonard Nimoy takes on a chili pepper, and here Leonard Nimoy's cranium is trying to catch ingredients to salsa. Bueno, Leonardo Nimoyo. All right, well, it turns out, and I'm not surprised, and in addition to being a very fine crooner, as we saw, Leonard Nimoy is a terribly skilled poet. So I decided to try a different, I think, very clever tack to meet Leonard Nimoy. I would send Leonard Nimoy a Blue Mountain greeting card that has Leonard Nimoy's own poetry on it. So here's number three, the Leonard Nimoy poetry card I sent to Leonard Nimoy. It says, Leonard Nimoy, thank you for a world of kindness. Thank you for your endless patience. Thank you for your sensitive understanding. Thank you for your love. Written by Leonard Nimoy, signed, Let's Have Iced Tea on Your Patio, Martin. I think that's going to work, don't you? Number two, lest you think I'm playing the dozens concerning my love for Leonard Nimoy, let me show you my devotion by playing Who Wants to Be a Millionaire, the Leonard Nimoy edition. Let's take the quiz. All right. Who is Leonard Nimoy's famous alien alter ego? Mr. Spock, of course.
of what religion is Leonard Nimoy? He is a Jew. Yes, let's move along. Getting there. Where was Leonard Nimoy born and raised? Boston. What was Leonard Nimoy's first movie as an actor? Kid Monk Baroni. If you haven't seen him as Kid Monk Baroni, you got to. Of course, I got the rest of the questions correct, too. Are you listening, Leonard Nimoy? And finally, number one, to settle once and for all that Leonard Nimoy and I should be best friends, BFF till stardate, whatever, I decided to take the CelebMatch.com compatibility quiz to determine if Leonard Nimoy and I would make a good match. So here's how it works. You enter in your birthday, mine is 8/18/75, and I'll click show my compatibility, and the powerful CelebMatch computers use biorhythms to see if we're compatible. Physically, we're 99% compatible, right there. Emotionally, 90% compatible. Overall, Leonard Nimoy and I are 74% compatible. So bring it on, Leonard Nimoy. Bring it on. And at any rate, if you want to search Leonard Nimoy on the internet, get all the links in the show notes, which you can sign up for at thescreensavers.com. And Leonard Nimoy, my email address is martin@techtv.com. Ling along and prosper. All right, Patrick, what's coming up?
I'm starting to really believe in restraining orders more than I ever did. ABC sportscasters Al Michaels and Melissa Stark are going to tell us if the yellow first down marker is a good thing or a bad thing, and they should know. They took out restraining orders on Martin, too. Stay tuned.
What are you doing this weekend?
Now this is freedom.
Try flying for $49. Change your life and your weekend. Call 1-888-BE-A-PILOT or check out
BEAPILOT.com.
You can fly, and for a lot less than you think.
Where to next?
Choose your adventure. Start for just $49. Call 1-888-BE-A-PILOT or check out
BEAPILOT.com.
Hey, Fred, my laptop crashed. Well, after I dropped it.
Oh, Fred, do you know the password I just changed my password to?
3 o'clock, Fred. Time to fry another hard drive.
Fred, I think I just crashed the internet.
Dealing with technology is hard. That's why CDW makes buying it as simple as possible by custom configuring brand name products to your specifications 1,500 times every day.
Hey, Fred, I fixed my laptop, but it still doesn't work.
CDW, the right technology, right away.
Howie, have a seat. Listen.
It's just like a movie theater.
Come to Radio Shack now during the Hollywood in Your Home sale and get an RCA home theater in a box with DVD player for just $299.99. And a two-room RCA DirecTV system is just $29.99 after a $70 Radio Shack mail-in rebate.
There's just one thing that's missing. A cup holder.
Radio Shack. You've got questions, we've got answers.
Yoshi says it's his favorite season of the year. Are you ready for some football? Monday Night Football starts today. And Martin was lucky enough to catch up with ABC sportscasters Al Michaels and Melissa Stark to find out if technology is helping or hurting the sports industry. Let's roll that tape.
Get off the internet and onto the couch because football season is kicking off. And who better to talk about the influence of technology on sports than commentators Melissa Stark and Al Michaels?
Everything's become so instantaneous. When I broke into the business, we had, among other things, a handheld calculator. I mean, that was the way you'd figure out a batting average. And it was tough to do it during the game. I mean, a guy would come into a game hitting 275 and he'd go 1-for-3 and he'd have to sit there in the middle of the game. And, you know, that wasn't that many years ago. You'd punch it in. I mean, now it's like, it's insane. I mean, you got every available statistic updated like instantaneously.
How much do you use the internet to research games and players before you actually get on the field to do the broadcast?
Oh my gosh, all the time. The redzone.org is very frequented on my computer. NFL.com, ESPN.com. So, I mean, that's where I get the majority of my stories and everything. It's great.
In years past, somebody would, you know, see something in the paper. And then they copy it and they'd fax it, and you know, by the time you got it, or even before fax machines, they would just, you know, send it out, regular mail, and by the time you got it, it was a dead story, old news.
Do you think that technology in some ways might sully a sports broadcast, for example, that little blue spot that followed the hockey puck around, the yellow line on the football grid?
We can overdo it, and obviously sports is on every station. You can get any game you want, so I think it makes it a little bit less special.
Can you hear me lending your voice to any video games, sports video games?
Yeah, in fact, I did. I'm on Madden 2003. You know, John brought me into his game. I mean, it's the most popular video game for kids, and I'm the play-by-play voice.
Thanks for being here with us. We're just about ready to start the game right now. So I'm Al Michaels.
Did you like the representation of yourself in that game? Is there an actual picture of you, or is it just your voice?
Yeah, no, well, there's a picture at the beginning, but it's mainly just my voice kind of doing sideline reports.
Right. Melissa, what can you tell us about his injury?
I'm told that it's a very serious injury, Al.
I mean, I've gotten more people coming up and going, you're in that game, you know, than maybe even see me on Monday Night Football. So it's tremendously popular. It's fun to be a part of.
The 10. Touchdown, Washington.
Ah, one of the most recognizable voices in the world. Also on our website, we have a bonus interview with Olympic medal winner Michelle Kwan. Be sure to check that all out at thescreensavers.com. Stay where you are, folks. We're going to read your emails, answer some final questions after this break.
Change for a dollar. Sure.
Introducing the all-new Chevy Avalanche. The only vehicle that changes from an SUV to a pickup.
Thanks.
Chevy Avalanche, Motor Trend's 2002 Truck of the Year. Avalanche, like a rock.
GEICO's always been about savings, but he really brought customer service to a whole new level.
We settle a ton of claims in under 48 hours.
Guaranteed claim repairs? That was his idea.
Customer satisfaction is at an all-time high.
You know what he represents? A commitment to excellence.
And he deserves this award.
GEICO. 15 minutes could save you 15% or more on car insurance.
It's not my dream to realize this day. The day a father watched his daughter start at Juilliard. But I embraced that dream with unwavering attention and made it my own. Because that was the dream of my client. And that's what I do at Morgan Stanley. One client at a time.
Submarine tick? How about the technology behind firefighting? The tech of an oil rig? An IndyCar? Even a roller coaster? Find out on TechTV's The Tech Of. The revolutionary new series that shows you how things really work. Go behind, around, and inside the technology of just about everything. Wednesday at 9:30, 8:30 Central, only on TechTV.
Next on Call for Help, it's no secret. Web advertisers are trying every trick in the book to get noticed. Everything from pop-up ads to hijacking your homepage. But we're going to show you how to outsmart them. Plus, you'll find out how to create a photo slideshow that'll play in a DVD player. We've got all that and more next on Call for Help.
Be sure to catch tomorrow's program. Actor comedian Drew Carey tells us why his show is embracing the internet. Well, it was about time. Plus, astronomer Donald Goldsmith, he's great. He's back to talk about space and time. And animator Danny Riddell shows off more amazing Maya tips all on tomorrow's television program.
Maya tippage.
Also, Brett Larson with a review of Jaguar OS 10.2. We might have some announcements from Paris because that's Jobs is there right now. And
You know what? Go to screensavers.com, read the show notes. We got some links there that talks about the security flaw, the major massive security hole at Windows XP we talked about earlier in the show. Please fix your system now.
Update, at least, at the very least, run the Microsoft Windows update and update SP1. I'm going to do that at home. However, if you're nervous about it, as sometimes service packs can mess up the system, we also will have a fix, a simple fix that you can do right now to prevent this terrible flaw.
Do it.
The point is, this flaw might just be one of many that we don't know about, so right. Service Pack is probably very important. Hey, we want to thank our guests. That's it for this edition.
Ray Kurzweil
was here. Melissa Stark, Al Michaels, Pat Norton, Leo Laporte. Thanks for joining us. We'll see you next time on the Screensavers. Bye-bye!